Let's reflect on past setbacks and hurdles you may have had to achieving your educational goals. One of the goals of the First Step Orientation Program at Craven Community College is to help you identify barriers or setbacks you may have had and to create a plan to help you overcome them in the future. The tool that we're going to use to identify and categorize any prior setbacks or barriers you may have had to education is one called Assessing Barriers to Education. Hi, I'm Anthony Nesbitt. I'm one of the instructors in the First Step Orientation Program here at Craven Community College. You know that more education can lead to better employment opportunities. The Assessing Barriers to Education assessment can help you identify some major barriers that may have been prevented you from continuing your education. By completing this survey, you'll be able to identify which of the kinds of roadblocks may have prevented you from advancing your education. Based on this assessment, you'll be able to identify which of the barriers are the greatest for you, and you can go about creating a plan to manage your own learning and overcome these barriers in the future. Okay, so let's look at the Assessing Barriers to Education assessment. Step one is taking the assessment. Okay, there are 40 statements. Okay, there's really no right or wrong answer. You're just going to choose the answer that most describes your concern. For example, let's look at number five. Number five says, not knowing what to expect. Is this a concern of yours? If it's not a concern, one, if it's a little bit of a concern, two, some concern, three, if it's a great concern, four. Okay, so you're going to choose your answer one through four based on the amount of concern that you have according to each of the responses. Let's look at number 13, not knowing how to apply to schools. Is that a concern? Is it a really big concern? If it's a really big concern, that would be four. If it's not a big concern, maybe somewhat of a concern, three, a little bit of concern, two, and then if it's not a concern at all, one. Okay, so you're going to fill out one of these for each of the 40 statements. Again, choose the level of concern that each of these statements is to you. Okay, so step two of completing the Assessing Barriers to Education assessment involves adding your subtotals. So once you've finished answering all of these statements, one through 40, you're going to look at each one of them. Notice that they're all arranged across rows in the page. Okay, so you're going to add the first two statements together, and it's going to go over in the subtotal category over in the far right. Okay, so number 1 and number 21 would be added together for the subtotal in A1. Number 5 and number 25, those totals would be added together, and they would go in the subtotal column B1. So you would continue to do that for all of them. After you have all of the subtotal columns filled, you're going to go over to step three. Okay, in step three, this is also where you're going to score your barriers on the profile. This step can be a little bit tricky. Okay, so after you've added your concern numbers together and you've entered them in the subtotal category, notice that each subtotal category has an A, F, E, P, or B. Okay? Now, you're going to take those numbers and enter those numbers on the line under the score in each of the barrier categories. Then, add those four numbers together to get the total score. That's going to be your total score for each of the barriers. Okay, now you should have a total score for each one of the barriers. You should have a total score for academic barriers. You should have a total score for your personal and situational barriers. You should have a total score for your financial barriers, a total score for your beliefs and expectations, and a total score for your educational planning barriers. Okay, once you have those numbers, you're going to use the profile at the bottom to help you visually know which barriers may be the ones that are your greatest barriers. Let's take an example of the academic barriers. Let's say your total score is 25. Academic barriers is abbreviated with the A. So you're going to find a 25, and on the line that has an A, you're going to put a little dot there to let you know that's where that barrier is located. F is for financial barriers. Look at your total score for financial barriers. If your total score is, let's say, 20, you're going to find 20 on the line with the F. Put a little dot there. Okay. Again, this is just to visually show you which barriers are your greatest barriers. Okay, now that you've indicated which are the greatest barriers that you face, step four gives you a chance to evaluate your most troublesome barriers. So take a look at the barriers that were the greatest to you. Maybe you have two or even three. Notice in the profile that those scores that are 25 or higher would indicate those are the higher ones. So examine the two or three that are just the most troublesome for you. Let's say if you happen to identify academic barriers and financial barriers as your two greatest barriers. Well, some of the things that may have led to a financial barrier could be just simply not knowing about the cost of continuing an education. You may not have been given the opportunity to find out what kind of resources are available to assist you with financial aid. We're actually going to be listening to Mr. Charles Weddington from Craven Community College, and he is going to talk to you about the FAFSA information and all of the other financial resources that are available through Craven Community College. So if financial barriers is one of the barriers that was one of your greatest barriers, there are resources here at the college to help you put in place a plan to help you move forward.